Hi, this is Dr. A with another immunohematology lesson. We're going to talk about ABO subgroups. Okay, so ABO subgroups are phenotypes that show a weaker or a variable reaction reactivity with commonly used polyclonal anti-A, anti-B, and anti-AB reagents. And so we're going to start with A subgroups because they were the first that were discovered and they're the most prominent. So group A red cells that react with your polyclonal anti-A and then with also with anti-A1 lectin are classified as A1 blood group. Your group A red cells that react with anti-A but do not react with anti-A1 lectin are then classified as A2 type or A2 red cells. So A1 and A2 red cells will react equally strong with monoclonal anti-A and for typing, so your normal anti-A reagents. And A subgroups are way more common than B subgroups. So sometimes when you see a weaker reactivity is because you have a decreased amount of antigens that are present on the surface of the red cells. And so 80% of group A or AB people, so people that have the A antigen, right, are A1, so the majority of people are going to be A1 or A1B, and 20% of people that have group A would have the A antigen, it could be AB also, are going to be A2 or A2B. So that's, I mean, for the 20% of anybody that has A could be A2, that's pretty significant. So the difference between the two types, the A1 versus the A2 types, can be both quantitative, in the amount of antigen present, and qualitative in the structure of the antigen, if you will. So the quantitative differences, A2 type has less antigens on the surface of the red cells, also meaning there are more of the H precursor, the H antigens, right? Because you have to build the precursor and then into that needs to be made into an H antigen. And then on that, you can add the A, the sugar that makes the A. Okay. And so, in these subgroups in the A2, what happens is you have plenty of the H antigens on the surface of the red cells, but they don't get all converted to an A antigen. And so in A1, they're all converted. You can barely detect any H antigens on the surface of the red cell. But with A2, you have some A and some H on the surface of the red cell. So having a lower amount of the antigens, the A antigens on the surface of the red cell is one distinguishing feature. This is also related because of that, or that comes from the fact that there is a lower amount of the transferase enzyme, the one that is needed to make type A from the H antigen to add that sugar. So there's simply not as many of the enzymes present, therefore not as many of the H antigens get made into the A antigen. And the H oligosaccharide can actually also branch some with the sugars, and the A2 has more of the straight oligosaccharides, meaning you can only add one sugar, whereas if it's branched, you could add two, so you could have a stronger A presence on the surface of the red cell. So A2 has less, so they have more straighter H oligosaccharides, and so they're not branched. They have, all of that translates into the fact that they have less A antigens on the surface of their red cells. And then qualitative, so there is a difference in the precursor chains, like we said, with the branching of the H chain, which that's it translates into quantitative and qualitative differences. There's a slight difference again in the transferase enzyme in its structure and active site. And then some of the A2 subgroups can make anti-A antibodies, anti-A1 antibodies. So this is only 1% to 8% of people that are A2. So again, within the A2, a small portion of them can make anti-A1 antibodies. And then about 22 to 35% of people that are A2B. So it is worth noting that they all have the same sugar at the end of that oligosaccharide chain, at the end of the H antigen. They all have this N-acetyl D-galactosamine, which makes them type A. So it's not a variation in the sugar. The sugar's the same. That's the sugar that makes it an A type. It's just a variation in the quality and quantity of that antigen on the surface of the red cell. So let's talk a little bit about anti-A and anti-A1. So in the forward typing reaction, anti-A reagent is used, and it strongly agglutinates both A1 and A2 red cells. But if you use anti-A1 reagent, which is a lectin, it's made from a seed extract and it reacts with A1 red cells. This will agglutinate A1 red cells or A1B red cells, but it will not agglutinate A2 or A2B red cells. So the A2 cells will also show an increased reactivity with anti-H reagents. And this is because there's a higher presence of the H antigens, because the A2 subtype, they're just not as good at putting that sugar to make the H into an A antigen. So there will be more of the H antigens present on the surface of the red cell. A1 and A2 will also both have anti-B antibodies in the serum detected in the reverse type, so that's what would be expected. But the anti-A1 antibody can be an unexpected finding in the reverse type of your A2 types. And so this is where you could see a discrepancy then between your forward and your reverse type. So again, your forward type is when you use reagent anti-serum to detect the antigens on the surface of the red cells. Your reverse type is when you use reagent red cells to detect the antibodies present in the serum of the patient. So again, this finding of unexpected anti-A1 antibody in that reverse type is only 1-8% of the cases of A2. But that would be a discrepancy in your typing. So the weak A subgroups, so this is infrequent and often found through ABO typing discrepancy. And this is only 1% of the subgroups encountered in the lab. So weak A subgroups have less A antigen, so there's either weak or no agglutination with the anti-A reagents, varying reactions with anti-B. You have variability in the detectability of the H antigens. So you have a stronger reaction with the anti-H because there are less of the A antigens present on the surface of these red cells. Therefore, there will be more H present. And the possibility of the presence of anti-A1 in the serum. So you weak A phenotypes. We're not talking about A2 subgroup. We already talked about A2 subgroup. This is weak A subgroups. So you weak A phenotypes are A3, AX, AN, AM, AY, and AEL. So of the subgroups you might encounter, this is only 1%. So you're more likely to run into an A2 than you are to run into any of these, and you may yet never see them at all. Your weak B subgroups are also very rare. They also show variable reactions with weak and mixed field reactions using your anti-B in your forward typing and using your anti-AB in your forward typing. But they can strongly react with anti-H for the same reason as weak A subgroups can react with anti-H. The H antigens are present. It's just in weak A and in weak B, they're not as good at adding that sugar to make them into A or B groups. So, being a B type, they would all have anti-A present in the reverse blood type. But BX and BEL can also show possibly a weak anti-B antibody present there in the reverse type. So your weak B phenotypes are B3, BX, BM, and BEL. Again, these are really rare. And then lastly, we'll talk about the Bombay phenotypes, another really rare occurrence. So this is an inherited genotype HH, so small h, small h, is autosomal recessive, meaning the H gene has been mutated into a silent gene and it doesn't make the H antigen. The problem is you need the H antigen to make the blood type, the A or the B blood type. And so these ABO antigens cannot be expressed because the H substance or the H antigen is not created. And these red cells won't react with anti-A or anti-B or anti-H, anti-sera. So no reaction at all. So they will phenotype as an O, meaning in your four type, there will be no reaction with anti-A or anti-AB or anti-B. So anti-A, anti-B, or anti-AB, no reaction there whatsoever. And you would expect to detect anti-A antibodies and anti-B antibodies in your reverse type. Bombay types, though, also have anti-H in their serum, and it's very potent because they don't make the H antigen, so therefore they can make anti-H antibody. And it can react at 37 degrees Celsius, so at body temperature or at incubation with your typing. The anti-H antibody in their serum is an IgM. It can bind complement and lyse red cells. And the implication of that is if you transfuse type O blood into a Bombay phenotype, those O bloods, if you remember, O cells are covered in H, big H antigens. And so the Bombay phenotype, the Bombay person has anti-H antibodies in their serum, and you give them this O with all of this H on there, and it's going to cause an immediate hemolytic transfusion reaction. It could be life-threatening to them. So the difficulty here is a Bombay phenotype person can only get transfusion from another Bombay phenotype person. And so it makes them really, really rare. Okay, so that wraps up our ABO subgroups, and I hope that this was helpful to you.